Isa, the son of Mary, will descend. How will he descend, Ya Rasul? His hand will be on the wings of two angels. He will be covered in two garbs, both tinged slightly yellow. Beige. Mahrudataini. Wadi'un kaffayhi ala ajnihati malakaini. Where, Ya Rasul? Inda manarati bayda'a sharqiyya Dimashq. Next to the white minaret at the eastern side of Damascus. And subhanallah, at the eastern door of Damascus, there is a white minaret. And there is the other one of the Umayyad Mosque. Both white minarets, they didn't exist at the time of the Rasul. But now it is there. So Isa will come down in that place. Then he will make his way towards Baytul Maqdis or Jabal al-Tur. And the ahadith say, the Muslims at this stage are thinking what to do. So eventually they come to this consensus. Listen, we can't sit here forever. Let's get out and meet them face to face. So they make this decision at night that tomorrow we will open the doors and go and take this on head on. And Fajr comes, Salat of Fajr. And the Adhan is given, and the lines stand up, and Iqama is given. And then Subhan al-Khaliq, the day or the area goes dark. The area, and the hadith says, so that a man cannot see his hand. It will go dark. And then when light comes back, they see in Isa is amidst them. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, he will lower his head and you will see like moisture on it, as though his hair is wet, but it isn't wet. And when he lifts it, beads roll down his head, like liquid, like pearls, and they scatter. And he comes to the Salat of Fajr. And the Prophet says, what will be your situation when Isa the son of Mary comes amidst you? Wa imamukum minkum. And your imam is amidst you. The imam is there. Isa alayhi salam. What will be your situation? So listen, the iqama is given and he notices that Isa alayhi salam comes. So he says, ta'ala, salli bina. Come. Lead us in salah. So in one qawl, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, Isa alayhi salam will put his hand between the shoulders of the Mahdi and say, ba'dukum umara'u ba'd, takramatullahi lihadhihi al-ummah. This is the honor that Allah Rabbul Izzah has given this nation. You will lead each other. So Isa will lead behind, will pray behind the Mahdi for this salah. And the qawl of the Ahl al-Ilm is, and in another narration he says, the iqama was given for you, so lead the salah. And then when the salah is finished, Isa, and the people are ready, do you understand? They were ready before Isa now for this challenge. That is why when you reach a level, Allah Rabbul Izzah will give you its solution. So he says, open the doors. So the doors open. And from afar, the Dajjal sees Isa alayhi salam. The false Messiah sees the real Messiah. And the hadith says he starts to melt like salt and water. Dissolve like salt and water. And he runs and Isa alayhi salam chases him. And calling, he says, it is written that I owe you one strike. I owe you one hit and that will come. So he catches him in the Bab al-Lud in Palestine. And in that place, in one narration with a lance and another one with a sword, Isa alayhi salam will strike and show the blood of the Dajjal in his sword. And the hadith says, had he were not to strike, the man would have melted to death. And the Dajjal and the battle with the Dajjal will be finished. And the Muslims have gone through a colossal test. And Isa alayhi salam will come to them and rub their faces out of mercy and kindness and give them the bashara. This is your place in Jannah. This is your place in Jannah. And as this calamity of the Dajjal has just finished, Allah Rabbul Izza will inspire Isa alayhi salam that, O Isa, another of my creatures is about to come out, and no power on the face of this earth will withstand them and outstand them.